Hey everyone, welcome to the session by Intellipaat. In today's world where we are surrounded by data, handling and maintaining this amount of data is a task. Well, it's easier with a lot of database technologies around us by making use of powerful languages like SQL and other flavors of SQL as well. In this video, we're going to have a quick comparison between SQL and MySQL and see what it offers to us. Well, before we begin with this session, make sure to subscribe to the Intellipaat YouTube channel and hit that bell icon so that you never miss an update from us. Here's the agenda for today. We'll start out by taking a quick introduction to databases. Followed by this, we're going to check out the basics of SQL as well. And after this, we can check out all the types of SQL that are in existence. And then we can quickly check out what MySQL is. And followed by this, finally, we can compare SQL versus MySQL head on. And guys, after this, if you have any queries, make sure to head down to the comment section below and do let us know. We'll be happy to help you out at the earliest. And guys, in case you guys are interested in end-to-end course certification in SQL, Intellipaat provides the SQL Core Certification Training Program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate at the same time. Well, without further ado, let's begin the class. So coming to the first point on the agenda, it's a quick introduction to SQL. Well, what is SQL? Guys, SQL is a standard language which is used for accessing and manipulating standard relational databases throughout the world. So when you've heard of SQL, you might or might not know what it stands for. Well, SQL stands for Structured Query Language. So the goal of a language such as SQL is very simple. It basically provides the user with a very powerful yet simple and efficient tool which can be used to work with and talk with a database where you're performing operations such as adding data onto the database, pulling out data, or even modifying and altering some data there. So how SQL fits into the world of databases is something like this. So at one point of time, data is actually generated by various sources. When you have to think about it, data coming from social media, it can be structured data or whatever it is. So all of this data, when it has to be put into a database, it has to be basically processed through the language of SQL. So SQL is a very simple language, which is extremely powerful, as I just mentioned, to actually go on to store data into your database and to work with it. And one advantage of SQL is that it stores data in a very structured way. When you have to talk about the DBMS where it works with, by DBMS, I mean the database management system. It's an RDBMS, which is a relational database management system, which SQL caters to mostly. And this ensures that your data is stored in a structured way, and at the end of the day, it can be accessed very easily and worked on effectively. This again saves a lot of time, saves a lot of space, and ensures efficiency is at its high. Coming to a quick introduction to MySQL. MySQL is again one of the first open source databases that the world had to see. And again, as I mentioned, it is an RDBMS system, a relational database management system, which ensures that the data, whatever data anyone is putting into the database, that it is very structured and very organized. So MySQL is one of these tools which is pretty much, as a database, which is when used alongside tools such as PHP, Apache web servers. This creates a huge dynamic package at the end of the day, which is very, very powerful, when you have to go on to data processing, storing it or using it alongside each other. When you've heard of MySQL, the meaning is very simple, guys. So when you have to say MySQL, it literally says MySQL, or you can say it as MySQL as well. SQL can be called as SQL or SQL, of course. So this stands for that. When you have to talk about a little bit more about MySQL. MySQL actually provides a very good feature, which is basically multi-user access. So more than one user can have the access to the database at every point of time. And this ensures that, more than one person can work on the data and, process the data, alter the data, whatever the requirement is. And this also uses SQL to query the databases, guys. So here's where one of your first differences comes in. MySQL is the database through which we actually use SQL onto. SQL runs on top of MySQL to basically query the databases and work with it. And MySQL database system, they consist of a wide range of database technologies. There are so many technologies that it supports. And all these technologies, they cater to users with different requirements, because again, there are many types of data in today's world, right? So to cater to what type of data is needed by what type of a database, here's where MySQL helps a lot. And then MySQL is actually named pretty much after the co-founder's daughter. The co-founder of MySQL is Michael Vidanius, and this was basically named after his daughter. And MySQL, again, as we have to talk about it, I have to stress about it, is that it is one of the most popular database softwares out there today. Just a quick info, guys. In case you're interested in an end-to-end course certification in SQL, Intellipaat provides the SQL certification course training program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate in the same. The link is given in the description box, so make sure to check it out. And on that note, let's get back to the session. And here is a quick usage of MySQL. Everyone from Airbnb, Uber, Netflix, Pinterest, Dropbox, Twitter, LinkedIn, every Fortune 500 company out there pretty much makes use of MySQL and more. And coming to the quick comparison between SQL and MySQL, the first point we're going to be discussing is the meaning. Well, so the meaning is pretty simple, guys. As I told you, SQL stands for Structured Query Language, and it is one of the most amazing language which is basically used to manage a relational database system. And what is MySQL? MySQL is the relational database system which is basically used alongside SQL to perform operations, guys. So any operations such as storing data, retrieval of data, or modification of data in the database. And this brings us to the second point, which is basically complexity. When we have to talk about complexity, you know, SQL as a language, it has to be learned on, it has to be worked on and practiced to ensure that you can make the most efficient use of your queries to work with your database. Then coming to MySQL, you know, MySQL is basically a readily available software, which is, you know, you can download it, install it and begin working with it without much of a prerequisite. And then coming to point number three, it is the type of usage that we have to talk about, because SQL is a very fine language. It is a very well-tuned language which is put together to work with a database, but MySQL is an entire database software, an entire platform which is basically making use of SQL to query the database, guys. Again, when you have to think about what to learn with, again, if you're using MySQL, then obviously learning SQL is a prerequisite. But then if you're just learning SQL, then you might not have to work with a MySQL database, because there are many other forms of relational database management systems where you can go on to use SQL as well. Coming to point number four is the purpose. When you have to talk about purpose, again, SQL is the language which is used to operate on the database, while MySQL is the tool which allows SQL to perform operations such as data handling, data storage, data modification, deletion operations, and much more. So I hope you guys are getting the general picture here. SQL is the language, while MySQL is the database on which SQL works with, guys. Coming to point number five is the usage. When we have to talk about usage, again, there are various techniques which SQL uses. You know, there are multiple code segments, code snippets, multiple commands, and pretty much everything else which, you know, is used to talk to various RDBMS systems. And in fact, MySQL is one of them. But then you have to talk about MySQL. MySQL is the RDBMS database pretty much, which ensures languages such as SQL can run on top of it. But then if you're thinking, how well does SQL run on MySQL, guys? It is extremely efficient. And even today, SQL is a very old language, and MySQL is a pretty old open source software too. From its day of the release pretty much all those years ago, it's still there. And I would not consider calling SQL or any of the MySQL RDBMSs as legacy, because as I told you, there are companies around the world, Fortune 500 companies, who make use of these every single day, guys. And then coming to point number six, it's updates. Because SQL is a fixed language, right? So no matter what, there are multiple flavors of SQL. Of course, there's Oracle SQL, there's some Microsoft SQL, there's multiple types of SQL, which is basically like a flavor of it. You can run pretty much if you learn SQL, right? So SQL is a fixed language. If you learn it, then pretty much you can all the code, all the commands, 99% of the code segments of the syntax pretty much remains the same. But then when you have to talk about MySQL, the updates are more frequent here, because at the end of the day, it's a software and it has to cater to various customer bases. But then even at the end of the day, solving bugs, making your software more efficient, or helping you work with your database management system in a more efficient way. If that requires frequent updates, then yes, MySQL provides that, guys. Then coming to the quick summarization of this particular difference, SQL, as I told you, it has been a big player. It has been a huge player in the world of IT, and it is very, very vital when we have to talk about the applications and its usage in applications, guys. And coming to MySQL, you know, MySQL brings about a software which pretty much makes the best possible way to store structured data into it on the database, and eventually to work with it later on by making the developers or the coders' life a lot easier, guys. And on that note, you have reached the end of this quick comparison between SQL and MySQL. Just a quick info, guys. In case you're interested in an end-to-end course certification in SQL, Intellipaat provides the SQL certification course training program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate in the same. The link is given in the description box, so make sure to check it out. I hope you guys took away a lot from this session. If you have any more points to add to this SQL versus MySQL video, or if you have any queries, head to the comment section and do let us know, and we'll be happy to help you out. And on that note, have a nice day. Thank you.